Gentlemen, and welcome to the virtual graduation ceremony for Northlink College. I'm Colleen Cosette, the Utilities and Business Studies Manager for the Education and Training Unit at Central Office, and for me it's really an honor to be your MC today. Like Colin Powell said, if you can dream it, you can do it. And a dream doesn't come and become a reality through magic. It takes sweat and determination and hard work, and that is why you are here today. I feel the excitement in the venue, I see the smiles on the faces, and everything contributes to this moment, even those tight graduation shoes that you're wearing today. It's all part of the process. So I would like to know, to inform you that this is our second virtual graduation, and we have esteemed guests, our graduates of 2021. Some of our graduates are here today, while others are doing the whole procession virtually, and they are watching us from home live. This, and therefore we would like all of our viewers to remember to show your presence while we are doing this virtual graduation. We would like you to like, to share, to comment, and show our graduates today that we are very, very proud of them. We are now going to stand and we are going to sing the South African National Anthem. I now call on our SRC executive member, Kanya Tunisa, who serves in the portfolio academic officer.
I am going to be reading you a speech that your president wrote for you guys. You made it. You made it through the long hours, the restless days and sleepless nights. It's your graduation day. Your time is now. And you've arrived at the end of a race as a winner. For most of you, during each day on your journey, you were faced with a challenge. You had to other things through to find an effective plan of action. You didn't lose yourself. You pushed through. You met the deadlines, even if you felt defeated. Sometimes you had to be your own motivation, even if everything was demotivating you. You proved the naysayers wrong, and the ones who believed in you, you've made them proud. It wasn't always fun, and it was definitely not easy. Struggling every day, you experiencing stress and being antagonized by the world to conform into something you're not. Overcoming obstacles at home, dealing with peer pressure, and fighting your internal conflict already made you a conqueror. But today you stand a victor. Over all trials and tribulations, your foot might have slipped along the way, but your walk wasn't hindered. Methods of success had to be changed. You assessed your situation and evaluated yourself many times, especially overthinking your decisions. But you got up at the crack of dawn to study. You stayed after hours to finish up the last piece of work. You are attending those practicals even though you weren't always sure you're heading in the right direction. Setting a goal is the easy part. Achieving it is where your character is tested, but nothing that comes easy is worth having. So be proud of yourself. Diplomas and degrees ain't handed out for free. Some days you thought, are there no good Samaritans around to lend a hand or a coin so that I don't need to walk far today or at least be able to purchase a bread? Even though nobody came to your rescue and you had to study with a candle and wear that same pair of shoes for months and end on end in every season you pushed through. At least more than once you had to question yourself if the struggles are truly worth all the obstacles. Others are able to sustain themselves and keep down a job while you were scrapping to get by. Some days were teary, but others were joyful. Even if you were only sun-kissed in that moment, you were happy. Not everyone comes from a broken home, but stability comes in different forms. You overcame COVID-19 challenges, and the pandemic robbed you of so much already, especially many people's dignity as all livelihoods. And even lives were threatened due to the depression, but you made it. That porridge on the stove 3 nights in a row kept you fed, warm, and fuzzy. Nobody needed to know, but you knew, and an empty stomach is the hardest lesson. Today, you are the victor. Just like you have authority to trample over serpents, you chopped off the chains of the poverty, the end broke the cycle of generational curses. You are the herd. You were always the herd. But now those who made you the tail will identify and proclaim your success. See, you don't need to praise yourself. Your hard work speaks for itself. So go forth with your head held high. Go forth with all the conviction that you've paved your way. And when you enter the room, others will acknowledge the light that shines through you. Be at peace with all people. Well done, students. We as the SRC and your fellow students salute you on a job well done. Congratulations once more.
Let us close our eyes. Father, today we come before you in gratitude, and we want to bring before you our graduates of 2021. They are on a journey of perseverance. They've been through many challenges, and right there next to you, and with your blessings and your love, you have brought them through this phase. And today we are here in celebration of this journey that they took. This graduation is an attestment of all their hard work and all the love and support they received from their family and friends. We bring those those supporters to you today, Father, for the courage and the motivation they gave our graduates, as well as the educators, the staff, and everybody who were involved in their lives. Father, we can only be grateful and thank you for your love and continued privilege that we have to be in your presence. Amen. Our SRC members spoke today of perseverance. They spoke of a journey. They spoke of challenges, of how they came through and how they have made it. And this is your time. This is your time. Your future lay before you. And we are just privileged to be on this journey with you graduates, those at home as well as those present here with us today. We are so, so proud of you. For we would like to just give our graduates a round of applause. I would like to call Adrian Stradom, our College Council Chairperson, to constitute this assembly.
By virtue of the powers vested in me as Chairperson of the Council of Northlink College, and in accordance with the Continuing Education Act of 2006 and the Statute of Northlink College, I hereby solemnly declare this graduation ceremony 2022 duly constituted.
Thank you, Mr. Stradel. I am very honored to call on our principal and CEO, Mr. Brian PK, to do the principal's address. Thank you, Mr. PK.
Program director is Colleen Cosette, the chairperson of the College Council, Mr. Adrian Stradom. Our guest speaker, Dr. Phumzile Mupe, the members of the executive of Northlink College, members of the College Council, and members of the academic corps present here today, student leadership in the form of the SRC, staff that has joined us, and indeed the honored guests, the students that will be graduating today. Good morning, all of you. It is not an easy thing to do, to speak, and especially to speak to people who will be leaving and leaving you alone. But allow me to say a few words and acknowledge that as the chapter at Northlink College draws to a close, the dawn of a new era is upon you. As the CEO and principal of Northlink College, I stand here today with pride and joy, knowing that we could form part of your tertiary education and a journey that has lasted up until the end of December 2021. And we have contributed to a society by shaping the minds of the youth and ushering in leaders of tomorrow. And I want to challenge you on the last statement I've made, that you become leaders of tomorrow. We want to be proud when we see you in leadership positions, and especially in government, so that we can identify with you as well. We are here today to celebrate and acknowledge the class of 2021, and we are aware that COVID-19 has impacted on all our lives and definitely have impacted on your studies as well. But I'm definitely sure that you preserved yourself and you pushed forward and made a success in spite of the challenges given by COVID-19. And I can tell you the perseverance that you gave to your studies during COVID-19 will definitely serve you well into your future. But I also believe that this is going to be the last virtual graduation. We want to go back physical. It is important to know that though some of you may continue on studies towards higher or other qualifications, others may choose to start their own careers, and others may move into different fields. Some may also start to work in fields that are unfamiliar to what you have studied. But to them, please remember this: education, whether formal or informal, is a lifelong journey that continues throughout your adult life. And I think you can get testimony even in this house. At age 65, there are people who are still studying, and you will not be the first ones. Please pursue further studies beyond Northlink College. You are never too old to learn something new. You're never too old to learn something new, and there is nothing that will stop you from studying further. It is important to tackle life with an open mind, ready to learn from anyone and from any experience. So tackle the new experiences wherever you will be going, learn from it, be brave, and make lasting memories for yourself. Getting ready to start a career is a daunting task, and you can take it from me, but very exciting time is in one's life that you should never let go. Remember, it is not a sprint, but a marathon. Some may find their place right away, and there will be those of you who will be sitting at home and looking for a job. And we know it is happening in our country. But never lose the focus on the dream that you had set for yourself. Dream big, look towards the future and what you want to achieve in life. But don't forget to live in the present and live it to the fullest. Each day is a blessing and a chance to shape a better tomorrow for ourselves and our families. So focus on what the new knowledge and experience you have gained each day will bring for you. And that can prepare you, I can guarantee you, for a better future. Opportunities come in various shapes and sizes, and sometimes right in front of us. So be ready to take up the new challenge that you will be facing as of tomorrow, when they present themselves to you. And I would like to invite you to also visit our website. Join our alumni committee that is soon to be established, and make a meaningful contribution to Northlink College via that particular platform. And from Northlink College, we want to thank you for being part of our family and wish you all the best for your future endeavors. And please, don't forget where you started, and that is Northlink College. I thank you.
Thank you, Mr. PK. Our CEO spoke about the way forward. He spoke about your future, what is to come, all your options that you have at your disposal. And for that forward-thinking view, that is where you go from today. The celebrations will happen, graduates, but there is another journey waiting for you. The world is your oyster. And for that, we thank Mr. PK. We would like to call our guest speaker, but before she comes to the stage, I'm so honored to call her to the front. I was able to go and view her profiles and to just see what she is busy with day to day. Dr. Pumzile Mope is a leadership communication coach focusing on strategic communication as a consultant and a facilitator. Dr. Mope has a deep understanding of communication and how to do it effectively, as well as how it influences leadership, teams, performance, and professional relationships. Her motto is lead differently and get remarkable results. And she does this through coaching, her consultancy, empowering leaders, and this is what she does in coaching programs. I was so in awe of this doctor and what she stands for. I immediately joined and followed and went in to see what she does. And I think we will all be so proud of her speech today. Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you so very much. You know, I often sit and listen to the part when I'm being introduced, and I must be honest that sometimes it feels like somebody else and not me that's actually being introduced. So thank you so much. That was very humbling. Program director, chairperson of council, the principal, members of council, management, SRC, and staff of Northlake College, parents and family of graduates of 2021, distinguished guests, and more importantly, the reason why we are here after all, the Northlake College graduates themselves. Good morning, Khuyamora, Molweni, and the one closest to my heart, Sanibonani. I am truly honored to be a part of this special day, special occasion. And I want to start off by thanking Nico Zilla and Ronaldo. Nico and I met barely 2 months ago, and subsequent to the first time that we met, we had a follow-up catch-up over a cup of coffee. I got to know him a bit better, and he got to know me a bit better. And he called me just yesterday, requesting if I would be available and willing to be a guest speaker today. But there is a very important reason and morale to this anecdote that I want to share as I get into my address this morning. And the very important morale, the very important teaching, is that opportunities are usually disguised as hard work. So most people don't recognize them. And I also want to add that success is achieved by one who is ready when opportunity comes. So it's important when that opportunity knocks on the door to seize the moment, like I did. Because opportunities are all around, really. But you actually only get to notice them when you really carry a deep sense of confidence in your readiness. So the phone call and the fact that I was requested to be here just short of 24 hours, it did not instill any fear inside of me. Actually, it gave me a feeling of excitement and anticipation, and I am just so expectant this morning that my message to you will not only inspire, but that it will motivate and encourage your hearts. And I want to start off by sharing a little bit about myself and make my address personal and draw 5 very valuable lessons that I would like to impart on you. So like I said, graduation is very, very special for me, very close to my heart. It always takes me back to 26 years ago when I was 18 years old. So you can add up the numbers and then you'll get to know how old I am right now. That's fine. So 26 years ago, I was 18 years old and I was graduating with my very first degree. And it was a diploma in journalism. I remember how excited I was and how proud I felt in that moment. And just to give you a timeline from that very first graduation when I was 18 and I bagged my diploma in journalism, I moved on and 2 years later, I graduated with my BTEC degree in journalism. And about 3-4 years later, I graduated with my honors degree in communication science. And then I went on to pursue my master's degree. And short of turning 40, so that was the best 40th present I could have given myself, I bagged my PhD. So 4 years later, after graduating with my PhD, I left my formal employment to start my coaching and consulting business in 2020. So it took me 20 years and 5 graduations to progress from a diploma to a PhD and to become a respected and recognized expert in my field, when I reached my ultimate PhD milestone, and it was really, truly one of the happiest moments of my life. I don't think I will ever forget when I took that first step on the stage as Mrs. Phumzile Mope. And when I got to the other side, I was Dr. Phumzile Mope. Yes, my academic rite of passage. So you may be wondering as you are listening to me getting into my address, oh my goodness, 20 years, like a whole 20 years. How did she do it? How did she hold it down? How did she overcome all the challenges? Because trust me, it wasn't plain sailing. And what did it take for me to pursue my dream so relentlessly? And I will tell you that it wasn't easy. And the answer to these questions is my message to you. So if you do not catch anything as I continue to talk about these five lessons that I would like to impart on you, please remember this. Never, ever give up. So people see success, like me showing up today, and I hope I do resemble someone that is successful. But people usually don't see the sacrifice. You know, the trials, the mistakes, the failures. And it is during those dark moments, the painful moments, those moments when things don't make sense and you are left with more questions than answers, that I would dig very deep and remember my why. And in remembering my why, that would help me to keep my faith. So one of my all-time favorite quotes is by Mark Twain, and it goes something like, there are two most important days in your life. And the first day is the day you are born, and the second day is the day when you discover why, when you find out why you were born. And I always add that there is a third most important day, and that is the day when you step into your why, into your calling. So this morning, I want to talk to you, the graduates of 2021, and I want to share my story and impart some of these valuable lessons that I've learned along the way. I hope that you will be inspired and motivated to continue to work hard and to never stop working hard until you reach your fullest potential and to fulfill your purpose and what you truly believe to be your calling. I was born and raised in a dusty township somewhere in Atteridgeville, Gauteng, Pretoria West, for some of you who are familiar with Pretoria. My mom is now a retired teacher, she's 76. My father, a retired psychologist, turned 82 this year. And I thank the Lord every single day for my parents who instilled an insatiable appetite for the pursuit of knowledge, who laid a firm foundation of hard work in my life and a love for our Heavenly Father. I started school when I was 4, thanks to my mom. I wrote matric when I was 15, and I enrolled at Technikon Pretoria at the time, now Tshwane University of Technology, at the age of 16, and I entered the world of work at the age of 18. I was married to my high school sweetheart at the age of 23, became a mother to the most beautiful girl in the world, Ngobile is her name, at the age of 24. And when I turned 28, I became a widow, a single parent to a 4-year-old who would never ever get to see her father again. So I want to draw from my own personal experiences, the trials, the tribulations, but also, as I was introduced earlier, from the achievements and the accolades, and to really just weave this together and share what I believe, and there are many, 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 many lessons that I can draw from my personal journey, but what I believe truly as you're about to close this Northlink College Cup chapter and step into your new chapter of your lives, what I believe are the five most valuable lessons as you prepare to step into your exciting future that awaits. And lesson number one is personal mastery. So back in 1996, when I was graduating for the first time, I remember during the academic procession, like today's procession, oh, that was very nostalgic for me, really, truly. So I saw the, you know, that the doctors, they're highly esteemed. There's just this aura about them, you know. So I would see these doctors and the professors walking into the hall, and I looked at the colorful academic robes, and I would whisper silently inside of me that one day I'm going to wear a robe that looks just like that one. And as I was remembering this moment in time, I realized that it was a defining moment for me. I realized that in that moment, I was speaking it. I was speaking that belief, that conviction. I was speaking it to myself and telling myself who I wanted to become in the world. And even though I didn't have a plan and I didn't know how I was going to get there, I had an impression which inspired my vision of what I wanted to be. So I am a product of both a technical and a traditional university, but I hold in my heart much respect for artisanship and vocational training sector and what TVET colleges can do for entrepreneurship, for uplifting our communities and our society in South Africa. I believe that in the context of the skills shortage in South Africa, Northlink College and other TVET colleges should become more and more institutions of first choice. This means that in South Africa, we have a collective responsibility to build a vibrant TVET college sector capable of absorbing many talented and ambitious youth, providing much needed skills to the economy and advancing entrepreneurship. And the reason why I mention this specifically is because I want you to realize that your journey graduating here is bigger than just you. North College has equipped you, it has empowered you, and what you are going to build with your acquired knowledge and skills is very much dependent on the choices you will make for yourself from today onwards. I remember when I was still staying in Potchefstroom before I relocated to the Western Cape, so that's in the Northwest Province, I met this one very, very nice gentleman who was so passionate about what he was doing. And I had called him in desperation because a pipe had burst. And he's a plumber and he comes to my rescue. And then we start to have a conversation. And I remember his parting words from the conversation that we had. He said, "I never wake up and go looking for a job. Jobs come looking for me." So the moral of the story once again is that don't wait for things to happen. What Northlink College has equipped you with today, it has exactly that same potential that can make people to come chasing after what you can offer the world. But it will require of you to look in the mirror every day and see your biggest competition. Your biggest competition is not the other person that you're checking out on Instagram or the other person that you heard about or somebody else that they are talking about. Your biggest competition, every morning when you stand there and you look at yourself in the mirror, that is who you are competing against. And you are competing against working on improving yourself every single day without ceasing. Lesson number two, clarity and commitment. So as you navigate through your own entrepreneurship journey, you will have challenges. But once again, going back to my keynote address message, giving up is never an option. Being in despair, never ever an option. It's okay to get tired and you rest, but you don't quit, ever. So not giving up firstly starts with asking yourself, who am I really? Ask yourself that question right now as I'm posing these questions to you. Do you know who you are? What is your vision for your life? What kind of life do you want in the future? How brave do you need to be to pursue your goals and to go chase after the vision that you have for your life? And the question that I always ask myself when I'm in this reflection space, what will happen if I do nothing? And that is always the question that motivates me to wake up the next day with even more vuma in me to go and chase after my dreams. So the answer to these questions really begins and ends with you. But I want to make this very practical. I believe that the creator of all mankind, God, wants you, each one of us, to fulfill our highest, truest expression of ourselves as human beings. So when you start to understand what you want to fulfill, when you start to understand the purpose of the creator, when he created you, you become connected and aligned with God. You feel connected to the source, and this brings about clarity of your vision for your life. Even if you don't have a plan, you must have some idea of direction that you want to go in your life. And throughout the years, my deepest longing and desire was to establish my own business. And my journey, as I said, I mean, it took about 15 to 20 years of me working, But the dream of owning my own business never, ever, ever, ever left me. And the important lesson that I want to impart on you this morning is that it is a journey, it is a process. You're chasing after the dream, but you need to be present and embrace each and every opportunity where life places you. Because if you become present in the moment, then you are going to awaken to the lessons that that specific environment is imparting on you, to prepare you and to position you as you continue on your journey to reach your goal. So there's never an opportunity that goes wasted, ever. And that is if you are paying attention and you are present in the moment. So ask yourself once again, are you clear on the vision for your life? Do you really know what it is that you want, who you are, who you want to be in the world? And until you find answers that align with who you are and the reason why you've come into this world, and the reason why every day you are still waking up and you are still breathing, then when you find that answer, know that you are on the right track and move on to the second most important step. And the second most important step is lesson number 3, to believe in yourself, believe in your dreams, and stay the course. I cannot overemphasize this enough. Believing in yourself enough to stay true to yourself. Believe in yourself enough to be brave. Be fearless when it really comes to chasing after your dreams. Challenge yourself to be the best you can be, because if you really think you can, and if you really think you can't, chances are you're probably right. And that's where it always begins for me. Always remember to be kind, and never, ever, ever, ever embarrass your parents, and never forget where you come from. So as you continue to work on your dream to fulfill your vision, remember to do the right thing, even when nobody knows you are doing the right thing. Do the right thing, and the right thing will follow you. Trust me on that one. If you are going to do a job, do it right. And the most important thing I've come to know about doing the right thing and making the right choices, is that there's a price that comes with that. People will not necessarily always like you. And they're not always going to be happy for you if you remain that principled and you carry a deep sense of conviction. And you know what? That's okay. And lesson number 4, grow through what you go through. I think throughout my leadership coaching, there is nothing that gives me a deeper sense of joy than to journey with someone in our coaching journey, and you see them come in and have a desire to transform and to develop and to grow and to become a different version of themselves. And you go throughout the journey and you actually see them grow and evolve and become that very thing that they so desire to become. So as I said previously, your competition is you, and the competition is growth. Success in itself is growth. So if you surround yourself with people who are not accustomed to your success, if you surround yourself with people who are comfortable in your older version and want you to remain there in your comfort zone, they probably will become fearful. You'll start to scare them somewhat, you know, because you are reflecting back something to them that they don't recognize. And my greatest advice to you is to surround yourself with people who are going to fill you up with positivity and good vibes. Find yourself a mentor and role models, that is, if you already don't have some. All of you living have the potential for enormous success. Opportunity won't always knock on your door, but the few times that it does, grab it. And when it does, and when it doesn't knock on your door, you build it yourself. When you get to the point in your life where you are doing well, it is important to remember to find a way to serve. We live in a world where everybody wants to be famous, especially now, you know, with followers and on Instagram and checking out how many likes you have on each post. And we also think that we are admired for being famous. We think being famous, being out there, brings value. And the truth of the matter is that all of that will fade in time, but service and significance you bring, that is what is going to last. So to be able to do whatever, so to be able to do your job or talent or gifts And to work with them to realize your fullest potential is what is going to give your life meaning. And once you have really reached that that level of self-actualization, give back. And remember also that it took a whole village, it took other people to make meaningful contribution along the way in your journey. Look at the most successful people in the world right now. They have a paradigm of service. You know, and that is the paradigm that one should always strive towards and work towards. To reach your goals and to become successful, you must also be prepared to fail. It's not a linear process of moving from success to success. You will fail, you will be tested to the core, you will make mistakes over and over again. But take all of these ample failures and turn them into valuable life lessons. Use failure as an opportunity to propel you towards growing, understanding yourself better, self-awareness, and really developing to a level of self-leadership and personal mastery. And what I love the most about setbacks, and I have tested this so many times, someday, if you would like to invite me, I will make it the title of my address, but there is nothing sweeter than taste. There is no sweeter taste like a taste of coming back stronger and hungrier. Trust me. And this leads me to the final lesson, lesson number 5. Stay hungry, stay humble, be patient, and stay focused. Keep your eye on the prize. It's okay to change your route to get to your goal as you try to find the best way to navigate towards it, but keep your eye on the prize and your goal. Don't never, ever let go of it. And you will never ever go astray if you do that. Opportunity won't always knock on your door, but the few times that it does, grab it. And when it does it, once again, you created yourself. And with that being said, I now come to, I draw to a close of my address. And I thought, and I hesitated, but I'm going to include this part because I believe that not only does it tie in with my message of never, ever, ever giving up, but that it will truly move and touch some of your hearts today. And I hope that it, if it does, that it becomes an anecdote, a story that you will remember during the times when you are being tested to the core. And this story is my own personal story. As I mentioned earlier on, that I once met most handsome man that I've ever laid my eyes on really in my life, and I was in high school. His name, Vincent, and we started dating, and we had so much in common. We both loved education. We had big dreams for ourselves. And at my sister's graduation, my elder sister, and she was graduating to be a pediatric cardiologist, he proposed to me. Everybody in the family, my sisters knew, but it was a surprise to me. And I said, yes. We get married, we are blessed with a daughter with the most beautiful eyes and smile. And one day Vincent fell while he was at work, and the doctors would later find out that he has a tumor. So the tumor, they tested it, and it turned out that it was cancerous. And not just cancerous, but the very aggressive cancerous kind. So the cancer was so aggressive that over time it took away his ability to walk, it took away his ability to use his hands. And I watched my husband, at just 30 years old, depend on people every single day to get out of bed, to take a bath, to sit on his wheelchair, to get dressed, to eat, to get in a car, to get out of a car, and yet he never, ever gave up. During his 8-year-long battle with cancer, he continued studying towards a degree in communication studies at UNISA. When he could not hold a pen in his hand to write his assignments, he did research and discovered voice recognition software and installed it on his computer. This technology allowed him to speak into a microphone connected to his computer so that the computer can type what he was saying. Even after he could not use his hands to write, he continued to study, submit his assignments, and write his examinations. Sadly, after a brave and courageous fight that he lost to cancer, he passed on in April 2016, and I hit rock bottom. And you know what sustained me during those darkest moments of my life? Is that I did not give up. I persevered. I did not despair. It would be the last and very valuable lesson that he would teach me, that I would carry with me to this very day. So throughout your journey from this point onwards, and especially when you are confronted with challenges, and especially when you have more questions than answers, when you have utter disappointments, failures, mistakes, you just keep on standing, no matter what, and you never ever give up. And I'm going to be honest with you as I come to a close, that it's not easy. Success is not for the faint-hearted. There is great sacrifice that lies in the road that you choose, but I believe that all of you, each one of you graduating here today, that despite your current circumstances, you have the potential to succeed in this life. And I know that the certificates, the diplomas, the qualifications that you are receiving here today are in the step in the right direction. So with that being said, congratulations to you and to all your loved ones who are celebrating you and celebrating with you. It is indeed a blessed day. Today you are reaping the rewards of your hard work, dedication, discipline, and perseverance. To the students, have a vision, believe in yourself, surround yourself with role models, and remember when challenges come your way to never ever give up, and you too will make a difference in this world. To the parents, pray without ceasing. Remember, you are your children's first role models. And I hope that my talk has inspired you and encouraged your hearts to continue to work hard and to never stop working hard until you reach your fullest potential. And lastly, seek God, believe and trust in Him for the purpose that He has instilled in your life and for your life in every reason, in every season of your life, and He will lift you up into His glory and goodness. Keep the faith always, and may God richly bless you. I thank you.
Wow, wow, ladies and gentlemen. The lessons she taught us about perseverance, about hard work, and most of all, nothing in life is easy. But if you keep on doing what you have to and move forward, it will all be worth it. We now move to a very, very special time in the proceedings. Distinguished guests, the class of 2021 will now be acknowledged for their hard work and dedication during the time of study at Northlink College. We would love you to give them a round of applause before they start with the presentation.
Thank you.
We will now call on the Utilities and General Studies top achiever who completed office practice level 2 to level 4 at Paro Campus. With an average, ladies and gentlemen, of 90%, we call on Zephny Van Zyl. Ladies and gentlemen, did you see the smiles, the excitement? Did you hear the crowds? I feel the graduation parties. I feel everything happening in the background. But let's first get to the end of this proceedings. Today is a day to remember, to reflect on who was really there, graduates, who was instrumental in your success story. Your family, your friends, the staff, your support structure. Northlink College of 2022, here at this moment, we congratulate you once again on your achievement. We wish you much success with your future. And remember, this is just but the beginning. You have proved that dreams can come true. Everything starts with a dream, like I said at the start. You can have the belief that you can do it. You can want to do it, but nothing will happen if you don't take action. Your perseverance to make your dream a reality, your patience and your hard work has made this dream a reality today. And for that, we salute you, graduates. I now call on Ms. Heloise Lutz, the academic head at Tigerberg Campus, to do the vote of thanks.
On behalf of Northlink College, I would like to thank all the graduates, the family and friends who joined today via our YouTube channel. And then to our guest who are present today, Northlink College Council Chairperson, Mr. Adrian Stradom, our guest speaker, Dr. Morpe. Thank you for your motivational and inspirational example you set for our students, and that they must grow into their own skin and never give up. To achieve their goals and successes. Giving up is not the option. Thank you. The Special Award graduates and the parents and guardians, we also want to thank family members and lecturers who encourage and support the graduates during their processes of achieving their goals today. Bunches of Africa for the beautiful flowers, Nikkei Productions for photography and videography, thank you. Cybac for academic attire, Encore Restaurant and Conference Center for the refreshments, our SSC executives being here today. We would like to express our sincere gratitude to our academic and support staff sitting here today and those who couldn't come to contribute to the academic successes of these graduates. Then a special thank you, a very special thank you to the marketing and communication team who arranged this prestigious event today. Thank you all.
We now call on Mr. Adrian Stradom to dissolve this procession.
By virtue of the powers vested in me as chairperson of the Council of Northlink College and in accordance with the Continuing Education Act 2006 and the Statute of Northlink College, I hereby solemnly declare this graduation ceremony 2022 duly closed. Thank you.
We will now exit the hall, and we ask that our guests inside the venue remain for 5 minutes after while we exit.